So, how do we get the delay out of this V here? Yeah, so how to turn the phase into a delay? So let's get us an idea of that. So let's draw one frequency here. So that's a nice sine wave here. So this could be one of these omegas here. And let's define a phase of 90 degrees. So that's our 90 degrees. So now let's think of a frequency which is half of this here. Yeah, so let's draw a longer sine wave here. So now suddenly we've got the 90 degrees here. Yeah, so if we now think of our delay, so this delay here and this delay here. So that's the one delay and that's the other delay. Then we see at the same phase angle here, 90 degrees, we are getting twice as much tau at the length here. So we are realizing that if we have the same phase angle here, you know, our tau becomes longer. So in order to normalize this now, what we do is that we are defining our time tau omega as d phi divided by d omega. And this phi is obviously dependent on omega, and normalizing our angle here with a frequency omega. And this tau here, this is called the group delay. So that's how much the filter is delaying a certain frequency here. So let's have an example. Example of group delay. So let's just write this group delay definition here again. There, so that's d phi over d omega. D omega. So that's our definition of the group delay according to the phase, and the phase phi of omega is arc of h of j omega. So now imagine we have a piece of music. Yeah, so this is your time, and so there's a music here, and then there's suddenly a does some drum kit hit, yeah, so like a pulse, like a short pulse here. That's our time signal here, x of t. So in the frequency spectrum, this pulse here contains loads of different frequencies here. So ideally, a delta pulse contains all frequencies, but this is a wider pulse, so it will contain a certain wide frequency spectrum here. So our x of f will probably look quite wide like this. So now imagine we are using a filter to filter this here. So our x of t, and we send this to a filter here. And we have our y of t. So obviously what we want to have is that after the filtering here, we would like to have this pulse shape here, or the moment in time when, for example, the drum kit is hit, or so that this stays together here, so that this is here still a pulse localized here. And this is only guaranteed if all these frequencies here, let's say, have the same delay. So in an ideal scenario, so ideally, tau of omega should be constant. So in analog terms, this is usually only achieved with the Bessel filter. In the digital domain, we have this much easier, and this going to introduce in a couple of slides later.